So you are ready to register for classes. You'll notice that we are already logged in to MyFVTC. From here, you will want to find the Enrollment section located on the far left and click the Add Classes link. Notice we can choose from three terms. I know I need to select the fall term, so I'll select that term and click Continue. The Add Classes, Select Classes to Add page will be displayed. There are two ways to add classes. We can either enter a class number or use the class search. I'm going to demonstrate both methods. Let's use the class search method first. We'll click Search, and the search page will appear. In many instances, you will know the catalog number, also known as the state course number, of the class you'd like to register for. The catalog number is used to identify a course name, such as written communication. Since we know the catalog number, we will enter it. I would like to point out the Show Open Classes Only checkbox. Unchecking this box will bring up open, closed, and waitlisted classes. We are going to uncheck this box to view all class options. To narrow down your search results further, click the Additional Search Criteria link. This allows you to search by specific criteria, such as days of the week or mode of instruction. It also gives you the option to search by the class title, using class title keyword, if you do not know the catalog number. For this example, I only want classes that are offered at the Appleton campus. Using the drop-down menu, I will choose Appleton campus, and then I'll scroll down and click search. As you can see, the next screen has pulled up a list of all written communication classes. You can see the screen is displaying one of three of 16 class options. I can click View All Sections to view them all. When I am viewing the classes, I can see some basic information about each class, such as meeting dates and time. I have determined that the first class number, 81718, will fit my schedule. Notice that this section is open for enrollment. If there was an orange triangle where the green circle is, that would mean that this class is not open for enrollment, but you can add yourself to the wait list. We will talk more about waitlists later. If there was a blue square there, it means that the section is closed and not available for enrollment or as a waitlist option. You can refer to the key located above the search results to determine what the shapes mean. Since we have determined this class is open, I will click the Select Class button on the right. On the next screen, I can verify the type of class, the days and times it meets, and the start and end date. So I'm going to click Next. Notice the message that is displayed saying the class has been added to my shopping cart. The shopping cart does not mean I am done registering. It just keeps that information available so I can select other classes to register for. In order to secure a spot in that class, I must first finish the registration process. Before we finish the registration process, I'm going to add another class to my shopping cart. We will add the next class using the class number option. I know the 5-digit class number I need to register for, so I'm going to enter it in the box and click the Enter button. Once again, it brings up information about the class so I can verify that I have the correct one. You will notice the orange triangle, which means the class is full and is accepting a waitlist only. To add myself to the waitlist, I will check the Waitlist if Class is Full box located to the right. If a seat becomes available, students will be enrolled in the order that they were added to the waitlist and will be sent an email confirmation. It is your responsibility to check your email to see if you have been enrolled. The automated waitlist process is discontinued 3 days prior to the start date, at which time you will have to check the classes for openings and enroll yourself. So let's move on. I'll click Next. The class has been added to my shopping cart, so I'll proceed to step 2 of 3 to continue the registration process. I'll scroll down and click Finish Enrolling. The Payment Responsibility Agreement will be displayed. You'll want to scroll through and read this. The agreement states that you will be responsible for paying for any classes that you sign up for and do not drop before the start date. After you have read this agreement, if you agree, click OK to continue the registration process. Once each year, you will be asked for information that the state requires. What you need to do is go through each question, such as work status and enrollment, and click the magnifying glass to look at possible values. You can make your selection by clicking the appropriate choice. Once you have completed that, you can click OK. The system will now process our enrollment. A message has been displayed indicating that we have been added to the waitlist for the one class. If you were not added to the waitlist, this message will not be displayed. We'll click OK, and the results of the registration process are displayed. You'll notice the green check marks to the right, which indicates that we were enrolled successfully in one class and added to the waitlist in the other. If there had been a red X in the status column, that meant that the process did not complete successfully, and you can read the error message to determine why. We've successfully completed the registration process. Now let's click the My Class Schedule tab to display your class schedule. You will want to go there and print your study list. The study list is a paper you can print out that will display your classes, textbook information, and any notes that you need to be aware of before you begin class. It's really important that you take the time to click the link and print it out. Also be aware that in order to purchase your books at the campus bookstore, you will need to present your study list. So you're going to click My Class Schedule and then click Study List and print it from there. Now that we've gone through this process, I think you're ready to register for your own classes. Good luck and welcome to FVTC.